Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. This is something that I've been super excited about for a really, really long time. I am finally announcing the new wheels for my LS400. So as some of you guys will know, I actually had a set of VIP modulars before. I was lucky enough to find pretty much a perfect set in used condition. They were built for an IS250, but they're a VXS310. Finished in triple chrome. They were at least 3 or 4 years old when I got them, and the finish was insane, not a spot on them. But I made them fit and work on my car. I absolutely loved that setup, but when I got those wheels, I did actually mention in the video that there was a specific set of wheels that I did want, and that was the VIP Modular VXS610s. I've actually spoke about this wheel for years, probably about 5 years now, as being my all-time favorite wheel, and so naturally, it is the wheel that I would choose for the final form of the LS. Now, back in early 2020, when COVID hit, I kind of decided that it was the perfect time to chop the car up and do exactly what I've been imagining for that car from the start. 3 years ago when I got the car, I had this vision in mind of doing a high radius, but really, really subtle. And I wanted it to look OEM plus, but have, you know, a more aggressive kit and pretty aggressive stance to it. And so when COVID hit and there was gonna be no shows, it was the perfect time to do that. After taking some measurements on the car, I kind of figured out roughly the specs that I needed to pull off the look that I wanted and started looking around for wheels. I decided I didn't wanna put the money into rebuilding those VIPs because I know that at some point I would have wanted to get these. So I was just trying to find a used set of wheels that were close to the specs that I wanted. So I kind of didn't have to spend any money to get what I wanted and mock it up around it. I ended up getting super lucky to find a set of rotiforms that had the specs that were really close to what I needed. And we ended up straight trading. This actually worked out perfectly because I got those wheels purely for the specs, used them on the car to mock up the wide body, if you can even call it that, get everything where I wanted it, get it on the ground, and then once they'd served their purpose, I sold them and put the money towards getting these, which are my dream wheels.
Oh, you can't show them on the camera right away. You gotta like go back. Cause if you see them before I do. All right, to premise for everybody, I bought these 10 months ago and I haven't seen them yet. And I figured I would do it here because it's a collab with a company, so I have shirts dropping with them too. That's way too much sauce right there. Giving them away, actually. Buy a shirt and you're entered to win. Just kidding. I wish. It's been like 5 years that I've been talking about these exact wheels, like in this exact finish. And finally, I have them. I'm gonna need to go next door. Just give a shout out to Prime Detail Supply. We're gonna go get some stuff and clean them up, but
fuck me. What do you mean?
Shout out to VIP Modular for being fucking amazing to work with. Sam, would you grab me a shirt, please? We have collaborated with VIP Modular. We've been working on this for 10 months now, and we are dropping a shirt with it. And then once the car is finished, we are dropping another shirt as well as a bunch of other items, which I am super proud to announce. Oh damn, I got two plate frames here.
Oh, one for me.
So, we had the VLS610 collab with VIP Modular. And then we have the LEP logo, which is emulating the VIP logo. And these are super limited to 100 right now. And then once the car is finished, we'll do another drop, which will have the car on it. As well as I think I'm probably gonna do this on hats. So that'll be exciting, but. This is hard. Like, how am I supposed to do anything at the booth? Because I'm just gonna fucking want to look at these. You know when you like finish, like you do something with your car and put it on the ground for the first time? You sit in the garage for like 6 hours and fucking stare at it. I just dropped the fucking thing.
Thumbnail.
Good fucking God. I'm scared to do that, I'll be honest with you, because I'm weak as shit.
I'll do it. I'll put it over my head.
No, dude, what if I drop my wheel?
I will.
Hey, it's great content if I fucking break these things.
I broke my wheel at Gatlinburg?
I just unboxed these. I need some shit to clean them
with. Oh, yeah, you got here. You want wheel
cleaner? Oh, exactly. So many, guarantee there's going to be people in the comments right now. They're like, dude, it's the same wheel as before. Okay, this is the guy that bought the wheels off of me. I really wish he had them with me so that I could put it next to that, because that is not even remotely close. I was supposed to do bigger lips, but I don't like it if you can't see the face. Yeah. So like, say the front wheel has like a 5-inch lip and then the back just has an 8, and you can kind of see the face on the front but can't see it in the back. I hate that. So I added back spacing to it. So it's 5.5-inch front, 6.5 rear, when it was supposed to be like 8.5. What have I done? Thank you, VIP Modular, for this. I fucking love you guys. Destin, you are the best.
So these wheels are loosely based on like the Mercedes or Brabus Alphard's wheels. I don't know if you guys have ever seen them, but it's like a 5-hole wheel with the little fins on it. It's a true directional wheel, so there is two different sets of wheels, left and right. For me, it's a very unique looking design. Now the rut forms were very simple. It was a completely flat face and it just had the 5 cutouts and that was it. It's just a teledial wheel. This has a lot more detail going on, and I obviously opted for some different finishes, and obviously the lips are stepped. Biggest issue with those rut forms was that they just weren't what I wanted. I literally got them for the specs. It just happened to be a coincidence that they were fairly similar. These are the exact wheels that I wanted. Let's dive into these wheels, what I chose to do with them, the specs, and the finishes. So if you couldn't tell from the clips, these are not polished. They are actually triple chrome, which is the exact same finish that I had on my original VIP modulars. For me, triple chrome just has tons of perks over being polished. Polished is great if you ever run into the issue of scratching them. You can kind of sand them down and repolish them and make them look good again. But polished has never looked this good. There is literally not a single polished wheel out there that has ever looked straight up like a mirror. I don't care who your buddy is with Alcoas that knows how to polish wheels, it's never looked this good. There's some downfalls of triple chrome in that if you scratch it, you really can't fix it, but the coating is so thick that it is fairly difficult to damage it properly. You just have to make sure that you take care of these. So leaving water on the wheels and water spots will damage the coating. But if you take good care of them, they will look this good forever, and they're very, very easy to clean. Beyond just the finishing of the lips and the faces, I did decide to add a little bit of color in there. Now, the color that I went with is a rose gold. This is something that will play into the car. I'm not gonna go too much into detail just yet, but we'll get there. And I'll give you a hint, it is something to do with the paint. So if you wanna take any guesses as to what color I am painting the car, leave them in the comments below. Yeah, I went with rose gold on the hardware, and I also went with a rose gold on the center caps. Now I have another set of center caps that that are just brushed silver, so I can switch it out if I'd like to, but I'm a huge fan of the rose gold. The little bit of color just adds another depth to the wheels. The rotiforms before were actually a reverse lip. Now, me personally, I'm not a huge fan of reverse lips, specifically for VIP cars. I think that the step lip just has a little bit more of a classy look and feel to it. And these specifically, being that they have pretty big lips on them, I think it just makes them look bigger and more detailed. The fact that it has deep flat bit right here and then it steps out, I think it just adds more detail to the wheel, and I love the way that it looks. These wheels are not actually VIP Modular VXS610s. They are actually VLS610s, and the L stands for the lightning pockets. This was an option from them. I'm not sure if anybody has done it on the 610, but it's basically between each piece of hardware, there is a little cutout and it's supposed to save weight. I obviously did not use it for that purpose whatsoever, because these are probably a pretty heavy wheel and I have no care in the world for saving weight. But they look really, really sick, and they're probably extremely difficult to clean, but it doesn't matter because it looks sick. Also, because it's VLS, we're just gonna go ahead and say that L stands for Liam, because they're my wheels. I decided that I wanted to work with VIP Modular because, as a company, I've seen their stuff for years. This is obviously my all-time favorite wheel, but I've also built like a relatively good relationship with them over the years from my old setup, them sharing a lot of pictures and videos of the car on social media. I just think that the stuff that they make is really cool, especially the fact that they are pretty heavily focused around VIP stuff, hence the name of the company. But they also have a performance division, which is called RSV Forge. So they make anything for, you know, exotics, big body sedans. I think they'll probably even make truck wheels. Literally anything that you could imagine you want a wheel for, they'll make it. And they've been around since 2004, 2005, I believe. So they have an insane catalog of knowledge on all kinds of applications. So if you have any questions when you're going through the ordering process, they will be more than happy to help you out and kind of figure out what specs and what look you're going for and what they need to do to get that look for you. Fortunately for me, I did all of the math on my own, told them exactly the specs that I wanted, and they were totally cool with that. And they have worked with me to make sure that I get the perfect wheel. It was back in, I think, the start of the year that I actually placed the order for these, and it shouldn't have taken that long, and this is nothing really to do with VIP Modular. If you guys have tried to buy anything this year, you will know that COVID has caused some crazy delays on supply for certain things, especially like metals and stuff like that. And so they were cut and pretty much ready besides lips and barrels for a really long time. And it's just because supply was non-existent. They did everything that they could. They were even making like trips to other cities to go check out other suppliers, and just decided that they didn't want to sacrifice the quality and that they wanted to make sure that what I was getting is exactly the quality that they would usually put out. So it was worth the wait, but we did have to make a few changes to the specs in order to get everything to work and get stuff here in time. All right, so the specs on the wheels ended up being 19 by 10.5 -25. That's with a 5-inch lip and a 5.5-inch barrel. And in the rear, I did a 19 by 11.5 -27 with a 6-inch lip and a 5.5-inch barrel. So I guess I can talk a little bit about the process of the wheels being built. VIP Modular have been amazing to work with this entire process. I want to say a huge shout out to Destin. From the start, when I initially contacted them about working with them, they've been super down with all of my ideas, and I'm excited to announce that not only do I have these wheels, but this is actually a collaboration with VIP Modular. Super excited about this because I'm sure a lot of wheel companies get people hit them up all the time for sponsorships and they just want free parts. But I'm very interested in building a good relationship and actually doing business with this company. And so that's why I decided it would be really cool if we could do a collaboration where we drop some merchandise and do some cool cross promotion between the brands and obviously make some sick videos like this one. For right now, the shirt design that I have is just of the wheel. These actually sold out at Gatlinburg this weekend, and I'm super pumped that everybody was stoked on seeing the wheels and wanted the shirts. So I'll be restocking those, but you can go ahead and order them right now. The link is in the top of the description. But once the car is finished and I'm able to get a good reference image of it, I will be having a design made that is the full collab. So it will have the car on there, the wheel, and it will be a really, really crazy shirt. Probably something similar to how the Bipu style shirt was with mine and Dallas's car. I'm hoping that I'm gonna work with like Hell Designs again. So stay tuned for that when the car is finished. But yeah, working with VIP has been amazing. From the start, they have sent me so many updates along the way. It's actually crazy. These wheels go through CAD design and stress testing for each application. So even though my car is utterly useless, it has a bunch of camber and I literally care about nothing but looks, these wheels are stress tested specifically for my car. And I don't know if all companies do that, but I know that there is a lot of wheel companies in the US that literally just outsource stuff to China to boost profit margins. VIP Modular is not that way at all. Everything that they do is in-house, and I think that's awesome, even all of their finishing stuff as well. Also, they are willing to do custom stuff. So if you wanted to do more concave, convex, you want to add the lightning pockets to a design that they already have, they can do that. And I'm sure if you were willing to pay enough, they'd probably make you a custom set of wheels too, which maybe we'll do that at some point. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see me work with VIP Modular to make a completely one-off set of wheels that we could either just have for my car or be something that we sell. I don't know, this is me just putting that out into the air. I've not spoke to VIP about it, but it would be really, really sick if I could design a set of wheels and you guys would be able to buy them. The next video, I guess, on the car will be test fitting these, and I hope that you guys are excited about it, because the last time I saw a set of wheels on the car that actually fit it with the Rotiforms at Christmas. And so seeing these, the exact wheels that I've imagined on that car for like years, is gonna be insane. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate everybody's support. I know that it's been a super long time that I've been hyping up these wheels, but finally they are here and I wanna hear what you guys think. Let me know in the comments below. And I'm literally gonna lose my mind the moment I see these on the car. But before I do that, I 100% need to go get them ceramic coated, and I have tires for them. So we should be ready to go here in like a week or so. We're gonna get a test fit on the car. But other than that, guys, please go click the link in the top of the description. Go grab those shirts. Unbelievably stoked on the way that these wheels came out. And we'll see you in a video on the car very, very soon. And thank you again, VIP Modular, for providing this opportunity. It's been a pleasure working with them. And hopefully this is the start of a good relationship and we can build some more wheels for future projects to come. So thanks, VIP. Thank you to you guys. And we'll see you in another video soon.